students and families. Welcome to our Monday morning assembly. We hope you all had a good weekend.
Good morning, St. Ignatius. Today is Monday, April 20th. Thanks for tuning in to our virtual assembly this week. And now it's time to stand up and wake up your brain and your body with some exercises from Mrs. King.
Good morning, St. Ignatius. Welcome back. I can't believe we're at week 5 already. You guys have worked so hard and we're all so proud of you. I want to take this opportunity to remind you to get up and move throughout the day. When you're starting to get frustrated with your parents or your siblings or your computer or yourself, that's your body telling you to stand up and move around. All right, are you ready? Here we go. Inhale in, come down, sweep the ground. One more. Awesome work. We're gonna bring our guard up and do some jabs. Are you ready? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and a hook. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Uppercut. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Let's take it a little faster. Ready? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Hook. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Uppercut. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Awesome work. Inhale up. Exhale down. A little balance now. Take that right foot back. We're going to bring it all the way up. Hands come forward and reach. Hold, hold, hold. Take those hands back towards your foot. Awesome work. Now take that left foot back. Come up nice and slow. Reach forward. And back. Awesome. Bring it down slow. Take that left foot in front. Left hand comes out. Right hand on top. Squiggly wigglies. Ready? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And up and out. Right foot in front. Right hand out. Left hand on top. Ready? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And up and out. Good. Inhale up. Take that right foot in front. Set it down, set it down, set it down. And stand back up. Ready? Down, 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 down. And stand back up. One more time. All the way down this time. Touch those buttons down. Inhale up. Exhale to heart center. Inhale out. Exhale to heart center. Inhale up. Exhale to heart center. Inhale out. Exhale to heart center. Last one. Up. And heart center. Namaste. I see God in you. Have a great week, Grey Wolves.
A reading from the first letter of Peter. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in his great mercy gave us a new birth to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you, who, by the power of God, are safeguarded through faith, to a salvation that is ready to be revealed in the final time. In this you rejoice, although now for a little while you may have to suffer through various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, more precious than gold that is perishable, even though tested by fire, may prove to be for praise, glory, and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Although you have not seen him, you love him. Even though you do not see him now, yet believe in him. You rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy as you attain the goals of your faith, the salvation of your souls. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Okay, so this Sunday at Mass, it was the second week of Easter, and we celebrated what's known as Divine Mercy Sunday. Raise your hand, how many of you went to virtual Mass with your families this weekend? Awesome. So, if you were at Mass, you got to hear the story of Thomas. We often call him Doubting Thomas because he doesn't believe that... He doesn't believe that... He doesn't get to see Jesus that first time and... I'm sorry. Are you seeing this? Can you... Huh? It's just hard. It's hard for me to. Is that an elephant? Did you guys see the? Did you see the elephant in the room? I mean, wow. Do you know what it means to have an elephant in the room? It's an idiom, and it means there's something really obvious to everybody, but nobody's talking about it. And today I wanted to talk a little bit about the elephant in the room here at St. Ignatius. Now, you've probably been talking with your families a lot about the coronavirus, the COVID-19, and it kind of stinks. But we haven't really talked about it here at Assembly, and maybe you haven't talked about it with your teachers, and I think we just kind of need to talk about it, because it's here and it's in the room, and it's not great. I'm going to use the help of one of our preschool students to explain how we all feel about the coronavirus.
The coronavirus, and it stinks.
You know, maybe it would help if we just kind of listed out some of the things that are hard about this. So I thought of some things on my list, and you can think of some more things if you have them.
So here are some reasons why the COVID-19 virus stinks. First of all, I miss my friends. How many of you out there are missing a special friend, many of your friends, or just being around kids and playing? Second, I miss my teachers. I mean, I love seeing their videos and all the lessons that they're doing and hearing their voices on Seesaw and Google Classroom, but it's just not the same as being with them. I know they care a lot about me and I care a lot about them, and I'm bummed. Three, I just plain miss being at school. Coming in the doors in the morning, playing outside at recess, eating in the cafeteria, seeing friends, just having all my school supplies and things to do at school. Speaking of food, I really miss Mrs. Kunkler's cooking. I don't know about you, but I'm craving a taco as soon as we get back to school. And who can deny Pizza Fridays? Five, I'm missing all kinds of fun stuff. Like, what about field day? What about our spring concert? What about all the fun things that we get to do towards the end of the school year when the weather gets nice? Such a bummer. And six, speaking about that, about graduation and baccalaureate. All you 8th graders out there, it's just not fair. You've been waiting for this moment for such a long time, and now it's going to be totally different. I mean, we're going to have a graduation still, but we know it's not going to be the same as if it could happen when it's supposed to. And not just things at school, but there's things in my personal life too. Like, my family had to cancel a big trip we've been planning for years because of the coronavirus. I was really looking forward to it, and now I'm not sure when we're going to get to go. Also, can we just talk about how tired I am of being in my house all the time? What I wouldn't give to go out to a restaurant right now, or go to the zoo, or go to a movie, anything. As much as I'm trying, it's hard to learn this way. There's a reason that we have school in school. I mean, there's some things about the computer that are nice and I can work at my own pace, but it's just not the same. Okay, and finally, I'm really lonely. And sometimes I get a little bit sad, and sometimes I'm scared. This is crazy. I mean, nothing like this has ever happened before. And I'm worried. I mean, I know everything's gonna be okay in the end, but some days it's just hard not to feel lonely or sad or scared, and not know when this is all gonna be over, and what the world's gonna be like when it is.
But, you know, not everything is bad about having a bed elephant in your room. Like, for example, with the coronavirus, my dog is super happy. He gets all of us home all the time. My dinner table's really happy. My family is eating dinner together a lot more than we did during the rest of the school year. You know, it's not all bad. I've had a lot of great time with family, and sometimes it's kind of fun to learn on the computer. So I think at the end of the day, it's important that you make your own list of the things that are really hard about what's going on in our world right now. So maybe take some time today to make your own list. What's a bummer about the coronavirus? What's hard on you? What are the things that you're really looking forward to having come back to normal? And then just know that it's okay to feel that way. And it's also okay to feel happy about some of the things that are different too. So however you're feeling, talk about it with your family, write it down in a journal, and know that we're all going to get through this together. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is we're going to surprise one of our students, okay? There's a scholarship that one of our students just received, and she doesn't know yet. So I'm going to call her on Zoom, and we're going to surprise her with this big award, okay? So, Ella, I know that we talked to you about maybe helping out with the assembly, but actually the purpose of this call is that I wanted to share with you some great news, and you applied recently for a scholarship for an award at St. Ignatius, and I'm pleased to announce that you have received the Otto Allenbach Scholarship. I'm so proud of you, and I wanted to be able to share that during this assembly. So the Otto Achenbach Scholarship, I'm going to tell everybody a little bit about it, okay? It's awarded to a St. Ignatius Catholic School student who is an active participating member at Holy Apostles Parish. It's somebody who's hardworking student and a good citizen at St. Ignatius. And everybody that knows Ella agrees that she meets all of those criteria strongly. So I wanted to share a little bit. Part of Ella's application, she was asked to submit an essay. And so, Ella, is it okay if I read just a little bit of the end of your essay?
Of course, yeah.
Thank you. Okay, so I'm going to read this last little bit of Ella's essay, part of the reason that she received the scholarship. So, she says, as you can see, St. Ignatius has opened up my eyes, showing me how beautiful my faith is. I admire and love my school because it is helping me form an incredibly strong relationship with our one and only God, the Father. I get to express my faith with my teachers and peers and not keep it secretive like I had to do in public school. By continuing my Catholic education at St. Ignatius Catholic School, I will value my faith even more and I will set the world on fire. Through my Catholic education, I have found God. So Ella, we are all so proud of you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for being such a model of what a St. Ignatius student is, loving, learning, growing, reverent, and a seeker of justice. And will everybody at home please help me in giving Ella.
Thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And now it's time for some announcements from Sentinels.
This week is Family Challenge Week. We encourage our families to complete the 5 challenges and post them on our Facebook page or send pictures to the St. Ignatius Sentinels email address. All families who participate will be entered to win a gift card. Here are the challenges. Number 1, Family Obstacle Course. Create an obstacle course outside that the whole family must complete. Number 2, Cook a new meal together. Spend some time together as a family in the kitchen and try a new meal. Number 3, 30 minutes of physical activity. Go on a family run, bike ride, walk, or hike and document it. Number 4, random act of kindness. Choose another family from our school, your neighborhood, or church, and show them some kindness. Leave a nice note, painted rock, or however your family would like to show them they are loved. Number 5, print off the I am missing page and share what you are missing most about St. Ignatius. Take a picture with your sign and either post it on the St. Ignatius Facebook page or email it to us at the address below. We look forward to seeing your pictures. Also, information will go out soon on how you can audition for the St. Ignatius Talent Show.
Please join me in saying the prayer for generosity. Lord Jesus, teach me to be generous. Teach me to serve you as you deserve, to give and not to count the cost, to fight and not to heed the wounds, to toil and not to seek for rest, to labor and not to seek reward, except that in knowing that I do your will. Amen.
Thanks for tuning in today. Have a great week, St. Ignatius.